concentrate here. Define some number of things. I'm going to do some examples related to those things. We will discuss in detail those examples.
Sir, इसी में आप की जगह n ले रहे हैं तो वो हमारी स्पेसेस आ जाएंगी.
And the integral can be interpreted as
something.
But you know, you can also treat them as separate entities. Okay. Anyway, so let's concentrate here. So let me define the sum of notion. Here's a definition. Do some examples for this actually. Consider a map F which takes values from R and throws everything into the field K, which could be R and C. The first thing that I'm going to define is what you call the support of the function. Support of function. Okay. Function F. So the support of function F is a pretty much interesting set, and the set is this. That it's a collection of those points of R, the domain of the function, for which the function is non-zero. For which the function is nothing. And then they'll take the closure of this. This set is known as what you call the support of F. You put in double B obviously, because if you put a single B, it gets you to another meaning of that. Support of F is the closure of a set, and that set is what? Set of all those points for which the function is non-zero. What does this show that? In other words, if you take any point which is not in support of F, what's going to happen? Huh? So it's not a linear transformation. so the function is going to vanish out
that.
So it's going to be zero roughly outside this support. So the support. So the support consists of all those points, okay, where the function is zero, and by taking closure means it also contains all those points which can be approximated by the points for which you know the function is not zero. So collection of all such points, okay, you would call it a support. And if you take anything outside support, function vanishes. Function has no meaning. And then the next thing that I'm going to define is obviously that F has a compact support. Compact. So when the support is going to be compact? So the support is going to be, so the compact support, if this support is compact, logically compact or not, and for compactness it
is
what
you need,
and I have put a theorem, border.
Yes, sir.
Closed and bounded. But it's closed already. There is no need to prove the closure of it actually. Just think about it. Because it's a closure. So the closure is closed. So the only thing that you need to do is that support of F is bounded up. So F has a compact support. If support of F is bounded. Okay? And what would be the meaning of boundedness? That is, there exist real numbers A and B such that support of F lies between A and B. What would be good thing about this interval A and B? The good thing about this interval A and B is that outside this interval A and B, the function is for sure 0. So if the support is sitting inside the interval A and B, so you are pretty much sure that outside this interval, in closure you can have a point. So what would be the better way to put it? So there can be points, not points basically, there can be the limits of the sequences such that the function may or may not be zero on the elements of the limits. Not limits, but on the members of the sequence. The function can be zero on the members of the sequences. But those sequences which kind of converge to some point, for there, you know, there the function is for sure. So in other words, okay. So you can easily deduce the definition. So closure means what? So X belongs to closure of this. Okay, it's not going to be like that. It's not going to be like that. So if I take an element from closure, this means that there exists a sequence except that approximates that X. So in other words, okay. It's a collection of all those points
which can be
approximated by the points
where F is bounded.
Yes. That would be a better way to put it. Okay, so the second definition is what we call a compact. For the compactness, we need bounded. We can see it. Also, pictorially, the function is going to look like something like similar. Okay, A and B. So the function can have any value within this A to B, but outside B, it's zero. Only exists, its values only exist, or non-zero values are only in the interval, what we call the closed interval. Okay? Third thing that I am defining is the space CCR. CCR is the space of all continuous functions with compact support.
Just is bounded on the side.
Huh?
Just is at bounded on the side.
What?
Which side? So it's like it's a collection of all those functions for which this support of it is bounded. Obviously it's going to be a subspace of space of continuous function. But for the continuous functions there is a trouble that you need always a closed term. Whole R have a bit of difference now. Okay, so CCR means the space of continuous function with compact support. Already see. So what is C naught of R? So the C naught of R is the space of those functions from R into K such that F is continuous. F is continuous and F has a zero asymptotes for X goes to infinity F. Maybe F of X goes to zero as X goes to infinity R.
X goes to minus infinity.
Plus minus infinity. So C naught of R is the space of all those functions such that F is continuous and F is zero when X gets bigger and bigger on either side of infinity. What do you think? What should be the relationship between this and this space? Yes, the first is subspace of the second one. Why? Because for the first we know that they are zero only on a bounded interval. Outside bounded interval they are non-zero on bounded interval. But outside that bounded interval they are always zero. And zero in general actually, whether X goes to infinity or not. Obviously you can include this. Are you getting the point? This is a subset of only a subset, but you can prove it, it's a dense subset. So which condition is weaker condition? This one or this one?
What? First one is weaker.
Fourth one is weaker.
Let's say third one.
So let's do some examples of this. Let's take some examples and try to discuss whether examples of those relationships with this, these four things that we have defined. So the first example, so I'm just giving a list of examples and discuss each of its relationship. Let's discuss these four things in the context of these examples. So the first example is the indicator functions. Example I is an open interval, near interval, same open interval. Then this function, which is called an indicator function. So the indicator function is so one of R. So it's like that's how you denote it. So some people denote it by chi. Like that, we should denote it by that, but probabilist mostly denote it by this. Okay. So, in indicator function is a map from the interval I into a discrete set 0 and 1. It's a discrete set. It's not an interval 0 and 1. Such that the indicator function of such that when it operates on the x,
it's 0.
It's not defined on I, but it's defined on the whole R. Okay. It's 0 when x is in R. Okay. Is 1 when x is in I, and it's 0 when x is not in I. No, I mean you can already think of, you know, all these four relations that while I'm writing these examples, you can think of already about that. Okay, what would be the support of this indicator function? Would that be compact? Will this support belong to this or this? So on and so forth. So
when this function?
Please think about it. Okay. Area. The second function that I am defining is a cubic function, what we call x cubed minus x. And the third function is x cubed minus x, the same function but restricted in the interval minus 1 into 1 into. So when I multiply something by indicator function, what does it mean? Yes. Keeping in view this interpretation, what do you think, what would be the meaning of this?
Same?
It's not same. It's so what you are saying that interval. If x is in this interval, I'm going to consider this what you call function, but when x is not in this interval, everything would be 0. So in other words, I'm considering only this function in the interval minus 1 to 1.
When it's
in. Minus
1.
So it's like when you multiply a function with the indicator function of some interval or set, you want to only see that function. So this is a function which is defined on whole R actually, obviously. But I don't want to see it on whole R, I want to see it on a particular interval, that is minus 1 to 1. I can multiply it with the indicator function and I'm going to restrict it into that interval. And the fourth example is, let's restrict it not in interval 1 to 1 but in 1 half to 1 half. Okay. Fifth example. Let's think in a relaxed manner that whether this function belongs to this interval, the first space or the second space.
And both PD.
Third
in the fourth.
Why not? I mean, you see that this function, you know, these spaces are spaces of the continuous functions. Is this a function continuous?
Yes, sir.
Is it a continuous
function?
Sir, A and B.
It's not a continuous function. Continuous on an interval. It's not a continuous function. So, if it is not a continuous function, forget about the second part, whether it has complex support or not. Okay, so it's a, you know, it would be a pretty good example. Can you have the functions which have components of complex support but not belong to basically this space? Indicator function is one such
example.
Similarly. So, this indicator function of the interval does not belong to CC of R and
continuously R is
intersection C naught of R, isn't it? So, it's not continuous on whole R.
Whole R will be pulled.
So, you need a continuous function which are.
So,
it's piecewise continuous, but not continuous. Okay. Let's think about the second part. So the second is this function. Right? So what are the points where the function is not zero?
So three points are zero, 1 or minus 1.
So what we are going to say that since function is 0 at 0, minus 1,
and 1.
Yeah. So I'll say that this sets x such that f of x is not 0 is equal to
R minus.
The interval minus infinity to negative 1.
Say union.
You want to explicitly
write it.
Union.
1 to 0.
Minus 1 to 0.
0 to 1.
Union.
0 to
1.
0
to
1. And then 1 to infinity.
Approximate your minus 1 and 0 and yes. Therefore the inclusion is on. So if you concentrate here, it would be better. Okay. So does this function have a complex support?
Continuous to it.
No. Does this function have a second constant?
No, sir.
So this is not a complex set, actually. This is not a complex set. It doesn't have a complex set. So if it doesn't have a compact support, does it belong to the first space? In order to belong to the first space,
compact support
must be there. It doesn't have a compact support. Okay. Okay. Let's think about it. Whether it does have something like that. So if you take x goes to infinity and minus goes to infinity, is it going to give you 0? It's not going to give you 0. So essentially,
CCR C naught are contained in it. So, agar ek element CCR
is contained.
Anyways,
f doesn't belong to R and C of R. We can compute it, suppose. But how about if I multiply? So see, all these examples are like experiments with you. Okay, so it doesn't have a. So this is a function for which we can compute support, but it's not compact. But how can we make it compact actually? Okay, the answer is you multiply it with a suitable indicator function. So let's see that. How about the third example? What we're gonna have? So if I write third example kind of more explicitly, this function says that this function is equal to x cube minus x if x is in the interval minus 1 to 1 and it's 0 when x is outside minus 1 to 1. Okay. This is what that explicitly says. So in other words, so how does this function is going to look like actually? So we have minus 1 here and a 0 here and 1 here. So how does it going to look like? So it's going to look like something like this. And something like this. Okay. So the first function, this function. Okay. So when I'm multiplying with the support, I'm saying okay. I'm not interested in this part, I'm not interested in this part, I'm interested in only this part of the function. Okay. This is what it is. So what would be the support of this? What would be the support of this function?
Minus 1.
It's going to be again the closed interval.
Minus
1 to 1. Or you can say you have.
Okay. 0 to 0. So 0 to 0. And then 0 to 0.
Closure. When you take the closure, it's going to cover everything. So the support is minus 1 to 1. So is this support compact?
Yes.
It is compact. So here's the question. Does this element belongs to CC of R actually?
CC of R, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
It does belong to. How about this one?
This method here. Containment.
Anyway, so for the rest of the function, think for yourself. So there are lots of other examples in the problem. So I think that you have to see that for the rest of the functions, think for yourself that whether it's going to be.
All continuous functions which you express that they are A to B internal there. For CCR,
it's not
necessary.
Compact
support.
So, okay.
What is the actual
compact? Subspace, yes. So if a function is continuous on whole R, it's going to be also continuous on the certain interval. That's correct. Anyway, Tegan, is it making sense? Okay. By the way, here is another question actually. You should add it into the list of these things that you have done. Is that in all of these cases, try to see whether f belongs to L1R or not. In all of these cases. For example, in the first case, if the indicator function is going to belong to L1R. In other words, if you integrate it.
Minus
1
to 1.
So it's going to be a simple integrate minus 1 to 1. 1 integrate 1 over the interval minus 1 to 1 because everywhere else it is 0. So it's going to be an open R. So similarly, think about the other functions, whether they belong to it. L1R are not active.
Support for the